Good morning. Roadblocks have been set up around Melbourne as police try to form a so-called ring of steel around the city to make sure residents are complying with the lockdown. Lana Murphy is live for us on the Princes Freeway near Geelong. Lana, that's one of seven major checkpoints set up this morning.
It is, Davina, and this one is especially important because tens of thousands of Victorians commute here along the Princes Freeway every single day. It is the main thoroughfare between Melbourne, which is in lockdown, and Geelong, which is not. But interestingly, in the 3.5 hours since we've been in town, we haven't actually seen police pull any residents over. They were forced to move their checkpoint, which was set up a little further down the freeway earlier this morning because traffic was building up too much. So they spent the last few hours establishing this one right behind me. Now, we were told yesterday, Davina, that this would not be a solid ring of steel around the perimeter of those 32 municipalities, and it would be more of a roaming operation. So we have seen busier setups in towns like Bacchus Marsh, Long Warri and Lang Lang, but there's also been a significant amount of activity within the border. So police patrolling a little closer to the city, making sure that residents aren't travelling unnecessarily from suburb to suburb. As we know, there's only four reasons you can leave your home. And if you are breaching lockdown, you will cop a $1,652 fine. We've already seen one of those issued this morning.
We'll be pulling up cars actively, randomly selecting vehicles and just checking what their business is. This traffic's very heavy. It's out of the ordinary. This is totally different from when the first lockdown occurred. This is just normal everyday traffic. So people are still travelling to work by the way.
Davina, once the force figures out these teething problems, these setups will be established throughout the day and night in the coming 6 weeks. Hopefully what will help will be the 260 ADF personnel, which is expected to land in Victoria in the next few days.
OK, Lana, thank you. Let's go to Isabella Staszkowski now, who has more on those affected by the Melbourne lockdown, including businesses forced to shut up shop for the second time.
Well, it's estimated that 15% of businesses will not be able to survive this new six-week lockdown. That's certainly something no Victorian wants to see occur. We were out and about late last night on Chapel Street as that lockdown was looming. The streets were bustling and each and every eatery was as full as social distancing would allow it to be. Speaking to venue owners, they say that they are prepared for this next lockdown as they've done it before. They're just going to have to strap in and do it again.
We just have to be as positive as we are. A lot of businesses are suffering and we're just going to get through it.
It's just disappointing really that you know, it got messed up for all of us, but you know, we've done it before, we'll do it again, and hopefully this will be the last time.
Businesses say they are going to need community support to get through these next 6 weeks. The best way you can support your local is to buy directly from them.
The Queensland government has just announced new restrictions ahead of the state's border opening up tomorrow to all of us except Victorians. Lane Kelcutt joins us live from Brisbane with the details. Lane, good morning to you. There are now even tougher border controls for those travelling from Victoria.
Yeah, Davina, there certainly are. As you say, they've just been announced in the last little while. Basically, if you're a Victorian and have been there for the last 2 weeks, you're not welcome here. If you do arrive at the border, you'll be turned around. If you arrive at the airport, you'll be put on the first flight home. There are a few restrictions, other restrictions. Let me go through them for you. If you're a Queenslander and you've returned from Victoria, you'll have to go into quarantine at your own expense for 2 weeks. The only Victorians allowed here will be those who have been elsewhere in the country, in other states, if you like, for the last 2 weeks. And if you do come here from any other part of the country, you'll have to agree to be tested if you show any symptoms in the first 2 weeks you're here. If not, you'll be fined $4,000. All this to keep community transmission on the other side of the borders. Here's the Health Minister and the Chief Health Officer.
Some people, some commentators, some politicians might choose to use those delays to criticise these measures, but we make no apologies for them. They are what has kept Queenslanders safe so far.
They can only come into Queensland if they've got specific reasons to come into Queensland.
And Davina, as you heard there, there will be exemptions, but not many, certainly much stricter than they have been before. Davina?
Mike Helcutt live in Brisbane, thank you. Let's go to Sydney now, where the New South Wales Premier has ruled out any immediate changes to the state's coronavirus restrictions. Chris O'Keefe was at that press conference and joins us live. Chris, good morning to you. What has the Premier said?
Well, Davina, we were all bracing for a tightening of restrictions after Gladys Berejiklian's press conference yesterday. That's where she flagged that things will get tougher here in New South Wales. But that hasn't happened. And the reason for that is our case numbers are still very, very low. 13 new COVID-19 cases overnight. 11 of them are in hotel quarantine. 2 are in Albury on the border of Victoria. And they were cases that have popped up on Saturday, but have now been confirmed after further testing. 2 have tested positive to COVID-19. Now, there is one more case, a person that they are going to double check, but they believe that that person does have coronavirus. They are in New South Wales at the moment and they're believed to have come in contact with someone who is from Greater Melbourne. But the truth is, given that the border is only closed in the last 24 hours between New South Wales and Victoria, Gladys Berejiklian says the state still needs to be on high alert because we will not know if there are infected people here and potential community transmission for a few weeks yet.
We won't know for a few weeks until all that seeding, the potential seeding, has been what we call flushed out. So we won't know for a few weeks to make sure there hasn't been any level of that community transmission kind of bubbling away under the surface, as can happen quite easily, as Melbourne has demonstrated.
Now, on hotel quarantine, the Prime Minister yesterday flagged that he's taking a proposal to National Cabinet to cap the number of international travellers. Now, one of the reasons for that is that New South Wales has done a huge amount in this area. We've seen almost 40,000 people come from overseas and go into hotel quarantine here in Sydney. Now, that takes soldiers, that takes 500 police officers every single day to ensure that that is properly policed. Now, people have known all around the world that if you are an Australian, since March, really, we've been told to be come home. But now the Gladys Berejiklian is saying that international travellers, if you are Australian and you come into hotel quarantine, in the next few days, she will tell you, you need to pay your own way.
New South Wales has done more than double what any other state has. We've welcomed back about between 30 and 35,000 Aussies coming back, going back to their home states. I won't be charging New South Wales residents ahead of charging those overseas returning travellers who've had plenty of time to get back to Australia.
Now, Davina, on that Jetstar scare a couple of nights ago, we've been told by the Chief Health Officer here in New South Wales, Dr. Kerry Chant, that New South Wales Health has managed to get a hold of every single passenger from that flight who came in from Melbourne, and they have now all been tested.
That is good news. OK, Chris, thank you.